Hello. Welcome to part two of this project. In part one, we created this box, and I left you with just the base of the box. Since then, I have covered it and added legs. So I covered the whole thing in the back, and then on the bottom, I just put the same paper that I was matting it because I didn't want to waste a piece of pattern paper for the bottom. And then I put the little legs. All these legs are some dowel caps. I think I got them at Joann's a long, long time ago. I painted them pink, and then I dipped them in a mixture of watered-down Mod Podge and gold eyeshadow. Let's see. It looks like this. Gold eyeshadow from the dollar store. It looks like this. It adds a lot of shimmer to these. So I thought the gold would help age it because it's a very aged paper, vintage paper. And it kind of did. So, anyways. And you can see my inspiration for this. It looks kind of like a jewelry box, I think. I saw a jewelry box like this on Pinterest. And I thought, oh, I want to make a box like that and put a mini album in it. So that's what I did. I created the mini album first. And then I created the box to house the mini album. And when we're all done, when we finish the mini album, I will show you another version of this that I created. So to start out, we're going to start out by covering our book. Okay, we have to put the book together first. So I have one sheet of paper in the color that I was using, cut in half at 4 and 4 1/4, and down the 11-inch side. And then I just glued them together. And I'm not going to use this whole thing. If I have to attach two pieces of paper, I really like to put where they join on the spine because I usually cover that up. That's just me. You can do it however you want to. So we have our chipboard for our book. And I have two pieces that are 5 1/4 by 3 1/2. And then I have a piece that is, 5 1/4 by 3 1/4. Those are the measurements, 3 1/4. I have a piece of paper or a piece of chipboard here that is 1 1/4 by 3 1/4. Okay, and the first thing we're going to do is attach that to our book. Okay, just like so. I'm going to center this right over my where I joined the two pieces of paper. Okay. And I'm always less careful about where I get my tape. Like here you can see I went way away from the edge. If I'm wrapping it, I don't worry as much. But if I was wrapping it, I would definitely make sure that my tape went to the edge of the chipboard here. So all I'm doing here is leaving a nice little gap in between the cover and the spine. And doing the same thing on this side. A nice even gap. Okay. There we go. Then I'm going to flip it over and I'm just going to run my bone folder over the whole thing. And then you can see here, this is where my extra paper comes up. And I am just going to cut it off because I don't want it on there. I don't need it, but I'm not going to toss it because I could make tags out of it. So I'm just going to set it aside for now with the rest of my scraps. Just like that. Then I'm going to trim off my corners here. There we go. Then simply cover the book just like so. A nice tight wrap helps to keep the book looking nice and professional. Okay. All of my corners are wrapped or folded now. Now I'm just going to run my adhesive along the edge. Just like so. Okay. And then I'm going to very tightly pull these around. And then rub them in really good. Pull these around. And again, rub them in really well. And then bend these in just a little bit. Very tightly pull that around. And same thing over on this side. Push in. Push in and pull around. Then I'm going to fold this up, and now I'm going to take my edge of my bone folder, and I'm just going to square off my corners. Because I believe that that gives it a nicer finish. Both sides. Okay. There's the cover of our book. Now we simply need to wrap the inside. Okay. So we just need to cut two pieces to cover the inside. If you want to do this part with pattern paper, that's good. It's a good time to do that. You know, I think I might. No, I'm going to cover mine with this paper because I like to keep my covers all the same. It's a little easier. I'm just going to cut it to three. Three and three. And then I'm going to cut one more that is three. Nope. Let's see. I'm going to need a piece to make my book is, yep, three. Okay, so we're going to cut this one. Two, three. I'm just going to set this piece aside for now. Whoops. And then I'm going to take this piece and I'm going to trim these because I don't want any overlapping. I don't, I don't need any more bulk in the center of my book than I'm already going to have. So I'm just going to cut these off, save those. And apply adhesive to these two pieces. Okay. Then stick these down. Oops, I forgot one step. I always like to apply adhesive to the chipboard on both sides of this gap. Okay? I just think it helps it fold up a little bit nicer. So I like to do that just to keep it looking nice when we close our book. There we go. Then we're going to do the same thing on this side. And again, I've applied the adhesive to both sides of the gap. And you'll notice that in the center here, my pieces of paper do not connect, and that is okay because my hinging system is going to connect them. All I'm going to do is just work my bone folder really well on those and then fold it up, and there we go. That is the base of our book. Super simple, super easy. Next, I'm going to take my scoreboard. I'm going to take that piece of paper that I cut 2, 3, which I didn't cut right for some reason. I didn't quite cut it to 3, and it needs to be no bigger than 3. Okay, so I gotta fix that little sliver there. Then I'm gonna take this piece and I'm gonna score it. Okay, my first score is going to be 1/2 inch. My next score is going to be at 1/4 inch. So I've scored at 1/2 inch, 3/4 inch. Then I'm scoring at 1 1/4. Then I'm scoring at 1 3/4. And then 2, 2 1/2, 3, 3 1/4, 3 3/4, and 4 1/4. Then 4 1/2. 1, 2, 3. And that gives me 3 hinges. Okay, then I'm going to take this and I'm going to trim it. Here, I'm going to put my last score mark on here. I'm just going to put it at the 3/4 inch mark and trim it off. It doesn't really matter how much you trim off there, but this is not my hinge system. This is not my design. It is just something. It is, her name will come to me in a minute. It is, what is her name? Oh, I cannot recall her name. I can't believe I can't do that. Okay, well, anyways, it's someone else's design. She uses this, Kathy Orta, she uses this, and it's just, I have changed it to my liking. Okay, so now I just applied adhesive to every other 1/2 inch score. And now I am just folding it, and generally, yes, it is easier if you pre-fold it before you put the adhesive, but since I was talking, I wasn't paying attention to what I was doing. Therefore, I did not do it right, but that's okay. Okay. So I've applied the adhesive to all of those 1/2 inch flaps, and then I folded them. And now I have, on the end of one side, I have a 1/2 inch flap. I'm folding that under. And on the other side, I have a 3/4 inch flap, and I'm just folding that under. Okay. And there we go. Now I'm going to open it back up, open those pieces, and I'm going to apply adhesive to my 1/2 inch flap. And then I'm also applying it to the inside of my 3/4 inch flap. Okay, then I take the 1/2 inch and I wrap it underneath, adhere it really well, and then I take the 3/4 inch and I adhere it underneath as well. And then I'm just gonna use my bone folder and crease all of these up. Just like so. Pretty simple, pretty easy. I'm going to take this tape, and the only reason I'm using this tape instead of my ATG gun is because this one I can pre-apply the adhesive. This is just one that's from, I think this is from Hobby Lobby. I do not even know the brand of it. It's just one I picked up from Hobby Lobby because sometimes you need to have tape that has a backing on it. I normally always use my ATG runner, but for something like this where you have to put adhesive on both sides, it's way easier if the adhesive is covered. And we're just running along both sides here. And one more. And then we're gonna start putting together our pages. And once we start putting together our pages, you're gonna see how easy these come together. Okay, now I have all my adhesive. I'm just gonna fold the hinges both ways and use my bone folder. Then I'm going to take my other scissors because they cut a little better when it's thick, and I'm going to cut an angle out of these because that's going to help my page fit over it better. Okay. There we go. All right. So now we have that going for us. We're all done there. We're going to take this piece here, apply our adhesive to the back side, and apply a lot of it. I'm going to overlap it and put a good amount on there because this piece is very important. If this falls out of your book, well, then all your pages are going to fall out. So now I've got my little piece here, and now you can see why it did not matter if the pages in the covering pages inside met, because this covers it completely. All right, so then I'm just eyeballing it and centering this right in there. Lots of pressure, make sure it sticks. And there we have our book. Now we can make our pages to fit into it. We're going to have three pages and they're going to be lovely. So let's start off with the base part of our page. What that is a 9.5 sheet of paper by 5. We need 3 of those. Okay. Then we're going to take our scoreboard and we're going to do some scoring. 9.5 sheet of paper. We're going to score this at 1/2 inch, 3.5 inches, and 6.5 inches. Okay, again, we're going to score this at 1/2 inch, 3.5, 6.5. And one more time, 1/2 inch, 3.5, and 6.5. That's all the scoring for the base part of our page. Then we're going to have 3 flaps, 1 for each page. And these are 3.5 by 5. We're going to put them in here and we're going to score them at 3. And the reason we're scoring them at 3 instead of at 1/2 inch is because if we score them at 3, then we know it is going to be exactly 3 inches, no matter if we were perfect on our 1/2 inch, on our over, our cut or not. So, sometimes I'm a little off on my cut, so I prefer to cut. If the measurement is important, I prefer to do it at that, at the end of it. Okay, so we scored all of those at 3. And then we're going to take our last pieces, and these are going to be little pockets. And these little pockets are 4 by 3.5. And we're going to score these at 1/2 inch here, here, and here. Okay. And then, and this part doesn't matter quite as much. If you want it shorter, you can make it shorter. But I left it longer because if you want to give this a decorative edge, that would look really cool too. So we put it in here with a 3.5 part at the top. We're scoring it at 1/2 inch, and then we turn it one time, score it at 1/2 inch, and then turn it one more time and score it at 1/2 inch. That is it. Again, at the 3.5 inch side, 1/2 inch, turn it one time, 1/2 inch, turn it one time, 1/2 inch. And that is all of our scoring for that. Okay, then we're gonna put that away. And we have a tiny bit of prep work to do. We're going to trim off the corners of the pockets. Okay. And then if you want to decorative punch the edges, now would be the time to do that. Then we take these. We're gonna score and fold these. These are our flaps. Score and fold. Okay. Take our little pockets. These are not right. I think that we may have scored these wrong. Yep, we did. We're supposed to score it on this side. I think. Yep, okay, that's okay. I messed up these ones, so what, these are 4 by 3.5, and all I did was scored it on the wrong, I just scored it on the wrong top side, but that's okay, because I could just trim that off, because that part doesn't matter as much. That's just the length of my, yeah, that's just the length. So I'm going to leave that. I will fold that down and leave it as the pocket. Okay. So we just have to do a little fix up. Yours will be longer if you do it the right way. But that's okay. I'm just going to fold that down. And now we have a pocket. That'll give me a doubled edge. Okay. Again, so I put it in at the 4-inch side, and you should score it at 1/2 inch on the 4-inch side and 3.5 on the 4-inch side, and then turn it and score it just once on the 3.5 inch side. That's how it should really be. But if you mess up, then you can just do this to fix it. So I'm just going to fold this over. And adhere that down. And the reason I'm adhering it down right now is because I don't want to forget that I've done that. Okay? So that's my pocket. And then my last pocket. Score again. This is at the 4-inch side. I'm scoring it at 1/2 inch and 3.5 inches. And then on the 3.5 inch side, we scored it at 1/2 inch. And that's if you're going to do it the right way, of course. If you want to do it a different way, then go ahead and do it the way that I did it. Okay, I'm going to fold this down real quick. Just fix that up. Adhere this down. And there we go. All right. So now that problem is fixed itself. I'm just going to crease up all of these folds. There we go. We got all of our pages creased. Now we're going to take this one. We're going to fold up our 1/2 inch. We're going to fold up the other one. And then we fold it one more time, wrap it around. Then we unfold it. Our half inch is here. We're going to apply our adhesive there. Then we're going to fold that back up. Adhere it, just like so. Okay, then we're going to take our flap with the half inch folded. We're going to apply the adhesive just like that. Okay, and then I like to stand it up on its end and wrap it around the flap that's already there. And then I adhere it that way. That's how I make sure that it gets on there nice and straight. Okay, and then I want to open it up, put my pressure on there, and then I want to make sure that I have this at the top. Okay, and then I'm going to fold it up. And this side, with my flap that I just added at the top, this side over here then is going to become my spine. So I'm going to flip it over, and then I'm going to take my pocket, and I'm going to apply my adhesive. And then this pocket is going to attach to the same side as my spine. Okay. Now your pocket will probably be longer than mine. My original pocket is longer than this, but that's because I messed up on this one. So that's okay, you know. And then when you flip it over, so you have that flap like that. And then you turn the page and then you've got a pocket here. Okay, and then you've also got a pocket in here. So when you open it up, there's a pocket here. We're going to punch a hole there. Fold this up. And then that, so that's the essential, that's the part of our page. Okay. So then you would take your book. And you would either apply your adhesive to this flap if you have, if you're using wet adhesive, or if you had not applied it. And then, find your opening here, place it on there, yep, and then, most importantly, make sure that it is nice and straight on your book. I like to lay mine down because then I know it's going to open and lay nicely. And then I press. Turn it over and press. And there we have our first page in our book. Okay, you can see how it looks. And it looks lovely. Let's do another one really quick. So we've got our page here. We're going to fold up our half inch. We're going to fold it up again and fold it up one more time. Open it all the way up. Apply adhesive to our flap. Fold it up like so. And then while we still have that open, we're going to grab another flap. Grab your next flap, stand it up. Wrap this flap around that one like so, and then we're just going to adhere that. Okay, then making sure we turn it around, we want the flap that we just adhered to be at the top. Okay, so this is our spine then. We flip it over, we grab our pocket, we add our pocket to the same edge as the spine, just like that. Simple and easy. We grab our book, remove the backing, or if you're using a wet adhesive, apply your adhesive, however you're doing it. Then find the opening in your book again and slip it down over that, just like so. And then lay your page flat, make sure it's lined up nicely, and press. Open it up and press. There we go. Opens up like this. We fold that up. We've got a pocket over here. And we've got a pocket in here. And then since we're at it, we might as well just do this last one. Fold up the flap. Fold up that. And then fold it one last time. Open it up. Apply your adhesive to the flap. Fold it up. Press it well. Take your extra flap that you cut, apply your adhesive to the flap of that, then stand it up on its end and apply your flap. Okay, then I turn it around to make sure my flap is at the top, and then flip it over, and I know I want my pocket to be there, because that's my spine edge. Attach this, and you can see once you get a rhythm going, this goes really fast. It's a super easy page design. Super simple. And there we go. We have our third page done. We're going to take off our backing, which is not really easy apparently. Then we take our book, find the opening. I just like to kind of pop it open like that. Slip it down over our page. Lay it down on the other one so it lines up good. And then lay it the other way and press. So now we have our book essentially done. All you have left to do is decorate said book. So, since this video is already so long, I'm just going to show you my decorated version. But now you can see that this fits right inside there, and you've got a lovely album in a box. So here's one that I made earlier. Now this one here, I'm going to leave the top like this because I like it like this. It doesn't need any flowers or anything on it. It's nice and simple. The paper is lovely, and it looks good. Now on this one, I kind of wanted to do up the top. I couldn't put anything on the cover because the book fits in here perfectly. So on this one, I did put some flowers on the top. I put a little bit of bling. I put a doily. I'm not 100% certain I like it, but it might grow on me. And then I also did put this crochet doily here and then another flower. And the flowers are, I just took colors that were